diva, same deal. Anybody play an instrument or music take music classes? Anyone? Okay. So this is in 4-4 time, and it's 32 measures, and there's 4 sections, 8 bars each, A-A-D-D. So you'll probably hear. Here we go. And I think I'm going to start by playing the melody on the drums, sort of the rhythm, right? And then they're going to come. Here we go. Sonny Rollins, Polio.
Thank you. same tempo. I don't want to be playing mine faster than he's playing his. or slower than he's playing his. That's how we stay together. So by tapping my foot to the rhythm that I hear, I can make sure that we're on the same page.
For me, tapping my foot is the way that I realize the time that we're hearing, and I'm actually making it physical, so it helps me. It's like my own personal body ritual.
Very good. So, any other questions? Let's have some more, or anybody else that would have any ideas? Yeah, here we go. Anybody else? So, any other thoughts? Yes, sir.
That like bar sound frequently using, or is just through the STs?
Very good question. It's very much of an African sensibility. Jazz began in one way in America, but really, you could say that it began in Africa. Because there's a tradition, which we're going to see a little later, of drumming and dancing and singing that have a lot of the same elements of spontaneous up and down. Spontaneous creativity and interaction. And all of those things are essential in African music, and they're essential in African American music. There were other elements added to it in the Americas, but that underlying connection among all the players, among all of us, to create intensity as a means to transcendence towards something beyond the world. Ancestors or spirits or celebration of life, that's from Africa, and you find it in jazz. So, to answer your question, its real roots are in Africa. Its current form began in America, but it can't be separated from its African heritage. So, anyone want to amplify on that? Good question. Is it from Africa or just from America?
Its roots are in Africa. That's where the many religions began, and that's where some of the elements of African-American music, where things like call and response, someone would raise a song, and then the community will answer, where you might hear it within the melody, where one instrument might play something, and another instrument will respond to that or answer it. So there are elements of the African music, but if not for the transporting of some of the African people to America and the experience that the Africans who were brought to America had, the experiences that they had, this music would not exist. Some of it is a form of expression for how they felt with the long travel across the water, growing up in slavery, working long hours in the heat, being separated from family, being separated from their culture, being separated from the language of their parents and their ancestors. All of these things led to an existence which expressed itself in the music. So in Africa, they didn't have that experience. And African music, traditional African music, is not jazz. But what happened to the Africans when they got here? When they got to the Americas, that's what helped to create this form of African-American music that is commonly known as jazz.
Okay, another question, another thought before we do our next piece. Anybody else? Any comments? Okay, so we're now going to do a piece in a different field. And the piece will be in a 12-8 field. Can you all clap along with this? Just clap like this. Good. Also, I'm going to have you do something different with your hands. Here we go with our feet. 1, 2, 3, 4. And now, get ready. See, this is not an easy move. Do your best.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was okay. Now, how about some questions for that? You're watching. Sige, sige.
How do you keep consistently within the diversity and spontaneousness and the complexity of the piece you're performing?
Okay, so that'd be a question. Did this sound like it was just one rhythm or time, or was there a lot? Did it seem pretty straightforward and simple, or was it more complex? So you were saying it feels complex. Okay, right, yes. Okay. So anybody want to talk about complexity and rest of the time?
We call them party rhythms when there are different rhythms going on at the same time. Not just one standard beat, but many, many rhythms happening all at the same time. This man is a master at being able to do 3, 4, 5 different things all at once. I have to look at him and have my eyes go like this. How is it possible to do that? It comes from years and years of study, years and years of practice. And even listening to it takes some time to really understand what's going on. So as I play on bass, I have to listen to not just the underlying pulse, where if I could imagine if I were dancing, where I would be putting my feet, I also have to listen to that bell rhythm, which you all played before very well. So, as we did before, that rhythm, that rhythm together with that underlying pulse, those were two rhythms that were happening. In addition to that, he was playing a drum language that would instruct dancers who knew the language what movements that they would do. So when we play this rhythm, the dancer might wave her arm, or when we did this other rhythm, they might jump up in the air, or whatever the drum rhythm was telling me. So in addition to the basic pulse and the metronome, the bell rhythm, there were also the language of the drums, instructing them on the movements to make. In addition to that, there was some improvisation. And not only that, we did different rhythms. We started out with that rhythm and finished with the rhythm that you heard before. But there were two others that went on in between. So lots of different ways of
having. We could ask Carter, how does he relate to on piano? Because that's a different approach and instrument to the African and here, the Ghanaian rhythms of this piece. How does he approach the piano?
Well, the piano is an interesting instrument because it has, this keyboard doesn't have any keys, but the real piano has 88 keys, so from the very bottom to the very high range, much more than most other instruments. And also, it's a percussion instrument because when you press a key, you hammer it to string. So that makes it a percussion instrument. But because I have all these keys, it also makes it a harmonic instrument. So I can change the way that the sound is and the textures are based on the notes that I play with. So, in this context, when I'm playing, for example, when the West was taking a solo, I was taking a very rhythmic pattern with my fingers. And it was sort of emulating what might happen with some supporting drums in a drum ensemble. So, I was using my fingers as almost like drumsticks. So, at the same time, adding color by playing the two notes that I'm playing. So, it's adding harmony and rhythm at the same time. So that was how I was approaching it. And I really love to do that with these guys because it lets me sort of play the piano like a drum, and I love to do that.
There was a great pianist, Cecil Taylor, that said, I play 88 tuned drums. It's so cool. And I wanted to mention that when Art was, I heard exactly when Art was doing that in Wes's bass solo, and as soon as he started doing it, I sort of withdrew and stopped playing for a while. Because it sounded so full, and it was such a complete connection that they were making, I just sort of, what we call, laid out, or I strolled for a minute. I just let it go. So you don't have to be playing all the time. There's a lot of freedom in this music. It's a really great thing for freedom. You feel very free about that. So, all right, another observation or question. We have some other thoughts, questions, comments on the music. So you could hear that it was pretty complex stuff, everybody. Okay. But you know the rhythm that you have, even though we were doing a lot of things on top of it, we kept that rhythm inside, even if there were moments when we weren't playing, just like you would in Ghana. Could you sense that rhythm even when you didn't hear us playing it? Or not necessarily? Would anybody raise your hand if you could hear the rhythm at all during when you're playing? Would some of you hear it? Anybody? No? Okay, maybe not. Okay.
I have a question. Because I'm not hearing from all of you yet. And what I would like, if it's okay with Roy, I wonder if you could all sing a song together. It would be new for us. And then I'd like to see what we might do with that. So can you all together sing a song, any song?
Why does a school anthem, you know, a school song here? Ateneo, how's your name called Ateneo? Are
you? Smart. The school song is...
Can I have a school song?
Did it?
So we're going to do one by a great composer. lifetime. And it's called In a Sentimental Mood. And it's sort of meant to be, do you have anybody, like maybe you have a friend and they moved away and you miss them, and you're thinking of them and you feel sort of sad thinking about them and you're on the way. Well, it's sort of like that. It's like you're in a sentimental mood. You're remembering maybe some time earlier in your life or a friend that you had and you miss them. So you're thinking about that. It's that kind of thing. So we'll play now Duke Ellington's In a Sentimental Mood. Here we go.
Thank you.
different than the other pieces? Any questions on that? Any thoughts on that before we go to some African panel? Any questions or thoughts or comments? Okay. Well, what we'd like to do now, I think we've got time to go over to some African drumming. So what we're going to do now is we're going to start with a little bit of an invocation and authentic and flute music. And we're going to ask... I forgot, we're supposed to take a few minutes break here. So we're going to do that and then we'll come back in just a second. Yep. Please.
You have quite a good distribution. Because we have to be really active for this part of this workshop. Because you have to dance, you have to sing, and you have to move.
Thank you very much for hosting us. This has been made possible by, of course, Ateneo University and the U.S. Embassy, and I believe that this is Arts Month in the Philippines, and interestingly, in the U.S., this is African American History Month. So it's a nice connection. And again, we want to thank the U.S. Embassy and the Office of Cultural Affairs and Ateneo University for hosting us. We'd like to start with an invocation from the Asante people of Ghana, West Africa. And then we'll follow that with some authentic flute music, which really is not based on Ewe drumming. Music of the Ewe people also in Ghana. So here we go. Yesua. 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 Thank you. from the Ghana people of southern coast of Ghana in West Africa. Can everybody, let's go with the all three groups that we've heard so far. The first is the Asante people. Let's all say that, Asante.
Asante.
And then let's say Ebene.
Ebene. Huh.
And now, what we're going to do, the next piece, Ga people.
Ga.
Ga. It's G-A. This music is called Palogo, K-P-A-N-L-O-G-O. And in English, we don't really have this combination of K-P, like that at the same time, K and P together. So it's K-P-A-N-L-O-G-O, Palogo. Let's all say that, Palogo. Yeah, good, good. Now, there's many songs in Palogo, and I'd like to ask you to help us to sing one. So these are the words. Ka'imi wawa. Good. Ka'imi wawa.
Ka'imi wawa.
Good. That's the first phrase. The second phrase is Ka'imi
lolo. Ka'imi lolo.
Say that again. Ka'imi lolo.
Ka'imi lolo.
Yeah, good. So together it makes the song. Ka'imi wawa. Ka'imi lolo. Let's try it together again. Ka'imi wawa. Ka'imi lolo. Let's do it again. And. Ka'imi wawa. And you know, when we were playing jazz a little while ago, you saw, you remember you were telling us that we were talking about those calm response? One of us does something, the other answers back. Well, it's the same thing here. I'll call the song and then you answer it. Let me sing it and let's see if we can match the notes. Ka'imi wawa, ka'imi lulu. And then you answer the same notes. Let's try it. And. Ka'imi wawa.
Thank you.
says, if you can clap, you can play an instrument.
Oh, that was good.
If you can talk, you can sing. You all spoke today, and you sang very well. If you can walk, you can dance. I think everybody walked here, didn't they? Yes. See the look of fear and trembling that come into their eyes. The fear of terror that they have to dance. In Africa, you can't even do anything if you don't dance. Even if you're a baby inside your mother, you're dancing because the mother is moving you. You feel it before you're even born. And babies are carried on the mother's back with their chest and face on the mother's back like this. So if you're seeing a woman in a wrap and a car, so if you see a woman coming, it's so beautiful to see. You don't see the baby, you're right in front of the woman, but you see the two little hands and feet outside of, you know, sticking out, and the baby's like that. So they're feeling the mother's body vibrate when she's working and singing and dancing. So the baby's learning to dance at a very young age. Everybody dances. So in that light, let's do this. Let's everybody stand. You just stay right where you are. You can put all your things down and stand right in front of your chairs. And I'd like to do two or three movements with you today. So the first one is going to relate to the well, they're all going to relate to the well. But the first one, we're going to clap our hands a little different. Two claps. And then we're going to do our movement left, right, right, but on one of them you cross over your right foot. So let me demonstrate with the bell, and we'll have you clap. So you can clap your hands too. Palogo, the nickname, or the short name, instead of Palogo, is Lolo, just Lolo. that song is Kainiwawa Kainiluno. So let's all get together, come from every part of the village, and we'll have a good time. We're going to dance this pomo and have a great time together. That's what that means. This next song is sort of just like an exclamation that we're having fun. Okay, say after me. Well, actually, let's just go over the words. Ba 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 ji ba ba o. Ba 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 ba. Ba 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 ba. Ba 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 ba. Ba 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 ba. Ji ba ba.
Ji ba ba.
Good. Ba 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 ji ba ba.
Ba 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 ba
ji ba ba. That'll do it all day. Let me sing the line. Ba 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 ji ba ba o ji ba ba. So we have, let's just say that whole thing with the extra ji ba ba. Here we go, again. Ba 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 ji ba ba o ji ba ba. Good, one more time, again. Ba 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 ji ba ba o ji ba ba. So I say that once, and then you start on my last note, but you go down lower. Let me sing the whole thing once, first part for you. Oh. before we finish today, I'd like to credit our teachers, because I am not an African person, and we always perform in public with somebody from the culture leading us. That it wasn't possible here in the Philippines to bring someone from the U.S. or Ghana, so I've asked our teachers, and they give me permission of us to share this music. There are great master drummers, Freeman Kwadzo Dongo, Abraham Kobina Azenya, Gordon Kwesi Agadri, C.K. Lazekpo Atapoku, and they have allowed me with permission, because this is not my culture, to share it with you. And that's just as true with the other wonderful world cultures that we have in this planet. Here in the north, the great tradition of Gamsa in the mountains of Northern Luzon, and in the southern part of the Philippines, the great tradition of Palabuni Kunyan, Kulintang music. And we're dedicating this entire visit to a great, great master artist of Kulintang, who just passed away in October. He's from the Philippines, of course, Anonggan Kalanduyan. And we want to honor his spirit with our music today. And what we'd like now to do is to give you a final piece that is related to this Palabo music, actually. It was written by a very, very tall man. He's about 6'8". He's now 90 years old. Is still playing great. His name is Randy Weston. And he wrote a piece called High Flow. And one interpretation is that when we play the music and we live life, we feel good, so we're flying high into the clouds. But before we do that, can anybody tell me, in all the music we've done here today, we did African, West African music, we've done African American jazz, what is there about those things? Do you see any similarities in them? Feel free to, anybody? Any thoughts on that? Anything you say about it? Well, I can tell you. Yeah, anybody? All right, they have, both traditions have something very distinct and similar. Yes, somebody. See, see nobody else. See nobody, Mr. Martin? See nobody? See
So it's sort of like there's this, whether the beat is fast paced or slow, it's like there's always this lull, and then it comes back again faster or happier. And it's always happy whether it's slow or fast.
Ah, okay. So there's a joy in it. Oh, you're absolutely right. Very good. Any other thoughts, reactions, comments, questions? Okay, yeah, it does. In Africa, and in this tradition, as jazz, music is a part of life in a way. It's specific for every part of life. If you have a child and you're pregnant, there's music and drumming and dance and singing for that. If you have just had a childbirth, music for that. Introducing the child to the village, it's called outdoors. It usually takes place within 2 weeks after the birth, there's music for that. Music for children, adolescents, adulthood, old age, honoring the elders, funeral music. When they, after someone dies, you honor the ancestors and the creator for work, for play, for everything, for worshiping the creator. All parts of life have music and dance and acting. And in my opinion, all is spiritual. It's always spiritual to the creator. So, we'd like to now play this piece by Randy Weston, and we hope that it does the same thing that African drumming and dance does. All these different complex rhythms come together to make one voice, one heartbeat. And the beauty part of jazz and African music and all traditions, including Kulintang, is they have all these voices that come together and create a single heartbeat. It reminds us that we're all part of one human family. Despite any differences we may have, we're still one people. In the words of a film that we just finished, we are one. So we're now going to play a jazz expression of that in Randy Weston's beautiful tune based on that relates to the Palabo rhythms called Haifa.
Just before we begin that, I'd like to say thank you to, I noticed that people are kind of shy here. So I would like to say thank you and have you also recognize the accomplishment of a brave young man who came up here and played the drums, Mr. Julius.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was many questions. High five. We want to thank everyone again. All of you come and working hard and gave us great attention and some wonderful thoughts. And Ateneo University for having us, also Public Affairs Office of the U.S. Embassy, and also everyone that has to do with this being National Arts Month and an American, African American history. We'd like to leave you with a great composer, Duke Ellington, whom I met once, really wonderful. Have any of you heard of Duke Ellington, any chance? He's a jazz legend. Anyway, he wrote a lot of great pieces, but he would often end each piece and every night that he played it, every night with it, a saying that we feel now for you. Let me introduce you. Over here that helped us so much with drumming, Miss Tony Bernardo and Toussaint Montez. Thank you very much. Faces is Wes Brown. And we'd like to leave you with a saying by Duke Ellington, we always like to say, because you've got such great audiences here. Each and every one of us, Tony, Tusa, Art, Wes, and myself, each of us would like every one of you to know that we do love you madly. Takami mamahal. We hope to see you again. Thank you.
Hi, on behalf of the Ateneo Junior High School Office for Student Affairs, we would like to thank Club Lunar Spirit with Mr. Wes Brown and Mr. Art Hirahara. And as a token of our appreciation, we would like to give you this certificate. I would like to present you with some token of appreciation, and just like what you said, you hope to see us again. So I told you in the beginning of this program that you will enjoy it. You see. Yes, as we have noticed, medyo shy na kayo, a bit shy, but because of music, all barriers were broken, okay? And you got a glimpse of what African music is, okay? So that it is something very spiritual, very deep, and not just about rhythm and sound, okay? So, Mr. Dr. Ronald Hartigan, we would like to present you the Certificate of Appreciation for being the resource speaker in the African Music Seminar and Workshop given this 17th day of February 2017, signed by Ms. Christina Mandalion, Mr. Ronald B. Capindi, and our principal, Dr. Carmen Horacio.
Back someday. I know it's the end of a long week and you're probably all ready to go home, but it was really enjoyable having you here. Your eyes and your dancing with us and your singing, it makes us feel good. So we hope to see you again, and all of us too. Thank you.